Look at my Texas Showdown 2024. That's all I got to say. All right. I didn't do all that, but I calmly walked by and I was like, and they're like, yeah, you're good. And I'm like, okay, thank you. Yeah. But in my mind, those damn kids. Nah, they were very nice. But I definitely felt a little embarrassed. I was like, I got paid to be here. Can I please get in? So anyways, I get into the partner party. They legit scan your badge to get in. So like they're just warning people ahead of time that you can't get in without an official clearance of the badge. So you get into through this first line of security. You go up this escalator and you lead to the outside, like second floor patio, which is extending from the convention center. They have a few other rooms secured. And I quickly realized there's a lot of damn partners. A lot. Because you would think with that level of tight security, it would be an exclusive event. No, this was so crowded. There were at least 1,000 people at that party. There was too many people. It felt just like an open convention center. There's more people in the party than in the badge pickup area. You know, it was just like, oh, things have changed. Because when I got partnered back in 2017, ancient history at this point, it was really like an Illuminati process. You could apply for partnership, but you were accepted or rejected based on a manual review with little to no reason given at all. There was no actual steps to become partnered. So the difference is now, if you reach certain metrics, there's actually like a status tracker in your creator dashboard, which will track your metrics. And then once you reach a certain requirement, then you apply. And then there's still some review. There's still some like manual rejection or acceptance. But there's a much more clear process now for how to get in. Back in my day, literally random people just got partnered because people knew who they were. Like people working for Twitch. It was exclusively like a who you know sort of deal. Obviously, if you had an overwhelming amount of viewership, you could not be denied at that point. Like you would get in. But beyond that, people were just partnered based on I had more viewership even at that time than a lot of people who were partnered far more and streamed far more consistently. I got rejected 3+ times. And then I remember one day I was talking to my chat like, oh, yeah, you know, the last try got rejected. But, you know, whatever, just got to apply again. And I think it was Chia. I think it was Chia in the chat who said, he said, oh, really? And, you know, he had the Twitch badge. You know, the Twitch cops showed up, everybody get down. And I was like, huh? He had the wrench and all that. And I was like, yeah. And then he said, refresh. And I refreshed the page and I was partnered. Which just goes to prove my point that it's a random dude flipping switches. But shout outs to Chia. Prove my point, exactly. But that was a pretty boss move. And I got partnered back then in 2017. And a lot of you guys probably in this chat right now were there. Like anyone who has a founder badge, I know Greg, a few others. They all were there that day. A lot of people watched to this day were actually in the chat at that moment. It was pretty awesome. I got like 70 subs right then. But anyways, times have changed. So that Twitch partner party, thousands of people were there. It was so many people, and I instantly was like, I am old. I mean, there's broccoli heads as far as the eye could see. It was just so many people, all of them, like, at least half my age. And I was like, what is going on? But I had not had any dinner till that point, and they had free food everywhere. I was like, thank God. I grabbed a few slabs of meat, slapped some butter on that, had a roll. I grabbed a beer. I was walking around like, hey, how do you do? You know, it was perfect. And so I was kept alive. So I wandered back and forth eating my food and then ran into Sage Jam, Emily, Automatic, met SK there and got to meet a few other people. We all kind of converged there. There was like a karaoke room. They're doing, I don't know, karaoke. Why? Anyway, some people like that. I'm not going to, you know, if it's for you, it's for you. They had all this stuff going on. But we pretty much just met up there and then we went out to eat. And then that's when we first walked through downtown San Diego. And this begins the phase of the event where basically Sage Am is just kind of herding his children throughout San Diego. Him and Emily leading the way. So at first we went to dinner and we went to some Italian place. At first it was going to be Mexican. We made called and Audible, but there's amazing restaurants everywhere. Lots of coffee shops, bars, restaurants all over the place. Tons of them, all within walking distance of the hotel and the venue. It was amazing. I really enjoyed downtown San Diego. It was really nice. Really, really enjoyed it. So it turns out it was also Emily's birthday. That caught us by surprise. So that's where we went out to eat. I appreciate other people documenting the event. There we are eating. JB, Sejam, there's myself, Infernasu, Yipes, Tasty Steve, Shine, Fumi, Gumi, SK, Emily. So happy birthday, Emily, once again. Which is crazy because there was another birthday right after that. Right, 2 days later, Shine had his birthday. And then here's her wonderful meal. Isn't it delicious looking? I had chicken. I was like, Italian. It's all carbs. I'll take the chicken. but looks delicious. Very good. Very good. So that was the first night. And then what happened next? What did we do? So Emily also gives me a coffee drink for the morning, which is great because the next morning I am actually working. So I had to get up even earlier. Normally I have to get up early for work because a lot of my team is international. But I have to get up even earlier because now I'm on West Coast time, which is 2 hours ahead of Central time. So I get up early as hell. I hate it. I feel miserable. And I literally brought two laptops. I brought my work laptop and I brought my gaming laptop to have for us to warm up for the slam. And when I wake up, I'm like, okay, let's get this day started. Here we go. Oh, thank goodness for Emily. She got me this coffee drink. I'll pop this real quick, log in, get to work. Here we go. And I tell you, this drink Emily gave me in a can, it was like drinking maple flavored battery acid. It was the most disgusting thing I have ever consumed that I can remember. And I am not a picky eater or a picky drinker. I was like, I almost literally did the cartoon, the sitcom thing. I was shocked. I was so shocked because it's a coffee drink. Okay, I'm leaking a little here, Emily. I'm sorry. I had to message her. I messaged her. I took a picture of it. Emily, this is the nastiest thing I've ever drank. I couldn't believe it. I could not believe it. So it's supposed to be a coffee drink, vanilla with maple premium coffee. And it has like very few calories. So it obviously has like a tiny hit of maple syrup, but it probably has a little bit of artificial sweetener, a little bit. And it's supposed to be like a nitro cold brew type of coffee situation. And I enjoy. So if you guys don't know, nitro cold brew or nitro coffee, it's used as sort of like if you ever had a Guinness beer, for example, if you've never had nitro coffee or anything like that, it's meant to add a nitro. It's not like carbonation. It's saturating it with the nitrogen in order to change the texture of the drink. And it makes it a lot more smooth, like a Guinness beer, if you've ever had that. It does. No, it's not. You guys are getting caught up on the wrong thing. The nitro thing is a real thing. I really enjoy nitro cold brew, nitro coffee, and nitro beers. I really enjoy those. It's a different texture experience. It's not sharp like a carbonation. It's a more smooth, and it's almost like it's a little bit, it's not like froth, but it's very, it makes it a lighter texture. Velvety, that's a good way. Creamy and velvety, right? So I was expecting a pleasant, creamy, velvety coffee experience. I love black coffee. I can drink it. It makes it taste sweeter. When you have nitro coffee, it makes it taste sweeter because the change in texture really influences how you taste things. So yeah, it's like a flat beer, but nice. Yes, that's, if you're expecting something carbonated, it'll taste flat. But if you're not expecting that, you actually can enjoy the texture a lot. But this was battery acid. This was sharp, harsh, boom. I was awake. Okay, thank you, Emily. You got me up.